For the first time since 2010, the Dukes have won their first three ball games, and only the fifth time in the 44-year history of JMU football. Hello, everyone. Welcome into the Coach Everett Withers Show as we talk James Madison University Dukes football with their head coach. Well, Coach, this last weekend's game, I had some people say it was unique, it was odd, strange, just a lot of things that happened in the ball game. But I think when you look at things, though, this showed a lot of character about your team, how it can adapt to a variety of situations, some in your control, some not in your control.
Well, Kurt, I think the biggest thing is our kids, they were resilient in the ball game. There were a lot of events that happened in the ball game. We didn't play particularly well, but our kids kept fighting. We talked all week about being relentless, and I think our kids were relentless in their pursuit to try to win the ball game. That was the bottom line. How do we go win this ball game after turning the ball over six times, some calls not going our way? There's a lot of things that happened, and after the game, I was very proud of our football team.
It was a 42-28 win over the University of Albany. It opened up Colonial Athletic Association play. I know you go in with a game plan, and certainly you have to make adaptations as the game goes on. But and a lot is talked about the offense, but I want to start today. You could not have won that ball game without sticking to the game plan that you did defensively, if nothing else.
Right. We knew that Albany was going to come in here and try to run the football, try to control the football. And we put our defense in some awful tough situations today. And I'm the hats off to the defensive staff and the defensive players for hanging in there and getting off the field as many times as we were able to get off the field. To be tied 14-14 at halftime was incredible, and hats off to our defense for putting us in that situation.
One of the things you want to do is win first down, right. And I did went back and did some calculations. I think on 14 occasions, you had them in a second down and seven or worse.
Right.
Other than maybe they picked up several of those actually in one of the drives that they scored. All in all, did that work to your favor?
Yeah, that was. We had a positive day in that aspect. The other thing that we were really good in on Saturday was third and three or less, which we had not been. And we were good on third downs, but we were good on third and three or less this week, which is that's the first time this season that we've actually won that statistic, third and three or less. So defensively, there were a lot of good things. There were some things. There were obviously some things we got to clean up and fix, but there were a lot of positives on defense.
Yeah, they ended up only 4 for 14. On third down conversion certainly stood out there. Okay, the turnovers, obviously they were just the real sore on this game, but and sometimes a great quarterback can have a bad day, and we kind of chalk that up as what happened to Vad.
Yeah, I think going in after looking at the film and spending some time with Vad and the offensive coaches, Vad, you know, at times you have a guy that's got a lot of talent that tries to make a lot of plays. And we've got some talented receivers, and sometimes you think you can just throw it up to them in the coverage and they're going to get it. We've had guys go get the ball in coverage this year. And, several of those interceptions were just poor reads by Vad, just throwing it up. So hopefully he learns from this. He had an excellent practice when we went back out on Sunday. He's the type of competitor that wants to go back and be better the next week. And we expect that from him. And I know the entire football team expects that from him.
What I found, it's one of those games that the math just doesn't add up in this game in many regards. I really anticipated that if you got 10 or 11 possessions in the game, knowing the way that Albany was going to kind of control the clock, that you'd be doing okay.
Right.
You ended up with 16 possessions in the ball game, and you got enough points to win.
Yeah, well, you got to think about it. Some of those possessions was because we turned it over.
Absolutely.
And got it back again. So that was probably the reason for the possessions. But, no, I thought our offense did a good job. I mean, we had 98 plays on offense. We had 40 first downs and over 600 yards of offense. So I think we came out in halftime and really got back to doing the things that we wanted to do offensively.
You wanted to run the football. Yeah. You indeed did. Yeah. And your young backs, well, Khalid's getting a little time on him, but with Cardin, both of them, they combine, you're getting a lot of productivity out of that running back position.
Yeah, we felt like coming into the season that was going to be probably the biggest strength of our football team, the running game and the running back position. And Coach Kerr has done an unbelievable job of getting those guys to a level each week of competitive excellence where they're ready to go. And we're fortunate to have two guys and really three guys. We can't seem to get Taylor in the rotation, but hopefully we can get that done this week.
Well, before we went into that game, you said that one of the keys you thought was going to be the kicking game.
Yeah.
And it's kind of a hidden element there too. Tyler Gray, I thought, did an excellent job of putting the ball where you want it to be put each time. And they averaged 19 yards per return,
right,
which is a positive as well.
Right, real positive for us. And Tyler's been doing an unbelievable job of kicking the ball off. And, we're excited and really happy to have him because he has a strong leg. He could kick the ball through the end zone every time, but he knows we want that ball where we want it, and he puts it there, and our coverage teams have done a good job. Better job this week than we did the week before.
Yeah, that's where I want to go, yeah.
But I think where his placement of the ball is allows us to be good on kickoff coverage.
Some of the numbers just continue to pile up. I mean, you're averaging 651 yards of offense a game, 51 points per game. The 41st downs is a JMU single game record. Just incredible. Did you see these big numbers coming this deep into the season? I know it's only three games.
Right. Well, I don't ever really look at what the numbers are going to be. You look at your personnel and you look at, what these guys can do and if they can do it at a high level and to do it consistently. And right now there's some things offensively that we're doing at a high level. We're running the ball very well. I think our offensive line is playing very consistent. We've got some depth on that offensive line. I think that we can put guys in the game and play. And they, when you start running the ball like that, there's a lot of confidence that's built between your offensive line and those running backs. And I think that's starting to happen in our offense. So did I see these numbers coming? I would be lying if I said yes, I did not. But I do think there's some potential out there for us to continue to get better.
Well, that's what I was going to say. You think you've also left 100 yards a game out there on the field, which is kind of your pursuit of excellence. Right. When you get 33 first downs a game, that's like compound interest.
Right.
Because you get another series of downs with everyone.
No question. The key is trying to, keep the ball and get the ball in the end zone when you got it. And that's our goal. And our offensive staff has done a good job of managing the game and calling the plays that need to be called.
I thought one of the key series was actually the third one coming out of the locker room where you grounded it out. You had 16 plays, 80 yards. It took a little bit over 5 minutes. So that, too, tells me you can score in a variety of ways.
Right. Well, when you come out after halftime and the way we came out, we wanted to start the game over. We wanted to go back to establishing the run. And for our guys to do that in the drive and take care of the football was really important. And again, hats off to our offensive staff and our kids for taking the ball and moving it down the score.
Each week we've seen more physical play. Yeah. And this week took a little bit more toll on the staff, on the team, that is, because we saw a number of linemen go down. But again, you found guys to step up.
Yeah.
Of the guys that we saw go down, anybody that we're concerned with that we may not have for a while?
Well, for a couple of weeks, I think Casey Kroll, one of our backup offensive linemen, will be down. He has a high ankle sprain.
But you never know about those.
But you never know. So, we're saying 2 to 4 weeks. Who knows what it's going to be? I saw him on Sunday, and he was optimistic that he'd be back sooner than later. And really, that's the only guy that we know for sure. Ishmael Hyman has a lower leg injury that, may keep him out this week. But other than that, I think we came out. Mitchell Kirsch, who went down, came back in the game. And I think we'll have him for Saturday.
How about your team awards this week? Did you name them once again?
Yeah, what we did, we gave out our Offensive Player of the Week, and that was Rashad Davis. He had a big ball game. He had a number of catches and a touchdown. And his biggest play, I think, was stripping the ball, after an interception and getting the interception back and recovering the fumble. So he had a big day for us. Defensively, our guy was Curtis Oliver, our freshman corner, who's played really well. He had 71 plays, graded out 96%.
Wow.
Five tackles, one assist, and three pass breakups. So he did a nice job for us on D. He's been playing really steady for us. And then in the kicking deck game, Steve Smallwood, another freshman, Had two tackles on kickoffs. Did an unbelievable job on kickoff return. Got his guy, had a pancake on kickoff return, and just was 100% successful in what we asked him to do in the kicking game.
All righty, so there you have the team awards this week. The Dukes, they are now 3-0, 1-0 in the Colonial Athletic Association, and they go one more non-conference game. That's next week at SMU. We'll talk about that later in the show. And we've got more for you coming up here after this timeout on the Coach Everett Withers Show.
Harrisonburg Nissan's factory-authorized year-end clearance sale is going on now. Harrisonburg Nissan has all in-stock 2015 Nissans priced at or below factory invoice. And you keep a rebate. 0% financing on Nissan Altima, Rogue, Sentra. All invoices clearly posted. Savings up to and over $8,000. We're clearing out the 15s to make room for the 16s. Now's the best time to buy. Harrisonburg Nissan's factory-authorized year-end clearance sale. Going on now. Check us out 24-7. HarrisonburgNissan.com.
So you can too.
That's right. At Office Products, we do things right. With our multi-million dollar inventory of new, used, and refurbished furniture, you're sure to find exactly what you're looking for. From desks to chairs, filing cabinets, and so much more.
All the major brands that you're looking for. Office Products, we buy right so you can too.
Office Products, we do things right.
Clear to zip.
Break a little. That's good. Very good job. Game on.
Hey guys, Coach Cisa again for your James Madison Dukes, defensive coordinator, inside linebackers coach. Today I want to talk about a little bit about our third down success on Saturday against Albany. Our best output to date, they only converted 4 out of 14 opportunities on Saturday. So I want to show you a little bit about what our plan was against them. Talk a little bit about the structure that we put towards them and kind of the success that we had on a couple plays. So basically this was the third down of the game, third and five situation. We had actually set this is a pressure that we like to run, but we actually set this pressure up on the very first third down where we gave a very similar look but didn't bring the pressure, ended up stopping them. But this time we decided to come with the pressure. So what you'll see in the screen is you'll see our safety Raven Green and our nickel Jordan Brown all looking off the edge as if they're going to pressure. And so what we're trying to do is this, is their protection often went away from the back, meaning that the center and all the O-line was going to go opposite of the back, so we wanted to bring pressure into the back. So what you'll see is both of these guys come off the edge. And again, the goal of this is to get two guys on one guy. And if they free released the back, then we would have had a corner in position to make the play. So as you watch the film here, you'll see the pressure. And as I freeze it, you'll see a good picture of two guys isolated on one offensive lineman. That's exactly what we're looking for. So one of two things will happen. Either the quarterback will have to get rid of the ball, or if he holds on to it, we'll have an opportunity for a sack. And he quickly gets the ball away to the running back here in this picture. And what you'll see is Curtis Oliver, our corner, who's in good position in the event that the ball was caught. He would have caught the ball for maybe a one-yard gain and ultimately still would have been a fourth down opportunity for them. But again, this is a pressure that's been good for us over the years, one that we really believe in. And again, we can bring a number of different looks out of this, from a pressure to a coverage. And so this was very successful for us. While we didn't have any sacks on Saturday, again, just the ability for us to bring pressure distracted the quarterback, and he got rid of the ball much quicker than we were anticipating, but led to some poor throws, and this defensive structure was really good for us on Saturday. So looking forward to getting down to Dallas against SMU this weekend. Going to have hopefully another good plan. They're really good on offense, but looking forward to it, and Next, you'll have a chance to hear from Coach Elliott talking about the offense's plan for SMU as well. So hope to see you guys down there. And if not, hope to have you guys following us and look forward to seeing you guys back home here in a couple weeks. Thank you.
All right, thanks, Coach Cisa. We're going to talk about one of our bigger pass plays of the game. It was kind of a coming out of the second half. We needed to get a spark going, and I thought Vad and the crew managed this very well. Basically, what we're trying to do is anticipating them playing man coverage, bring some sort of pressure. So it's a drop back pass, six-man protection, trying to isolate Rashard here, our number three receiver, on one of their lesser athletes of a safety or a linebacker. And in this case, we get their safety. And we're running a corner route, basically high-low in the field, corner back. If you can see, it's a little bit of a reflection there. But basically, we got man-to-man coverage, and the read is throwing the back corner pylon, and you got two ends outside in case they fall off in zone. But it's really a man-beating concept. Most everybody in the country has this concept in. Johnny Manziel got drafted from this concept alone. All you're doing is just basically a three-step drop, read in the back corner. The result was pretty good. We had good protection on this play, and Vad did a nice job of delivering a good ball, and Rashard did a good job of winning, staying vertical, and giving Vad some room to throw. Great protection by the offensive line as well.
Every time we get to hear from those gentlemen, we learn something new about JMU football, thanks to Coach Cisa and to Coach Elliott there, here with a little Chalk Talk. When we come back, we'll have a little chat. Actually, it's Cat Maniantakis. We'll talk with Dom Richards, the center of the Dukes of James Madison, after this timeout here on the Coach Everett Withers Show.
Harrisonburg Nissan's factory-authorized year-end clearance sale is going on now. Harrisonburg Nissan has all in-stock 2015 Nissans priced at or below factory invoice. And you keep the rebates. 0% financing on Nissan Altima, Rogue, Sentra. All invoices clearly posted. Savings up to and over $8,000. We're clearing out the 15s to make room for the 16s. Now's the best time to buy. Harrisonburg Nissan's factory-authorized year-end clearance sale. Going on now. Check us out 24-7. HarrisonburgNissan.com.
So you can too.
That's right. At Office Products, we do things right. With our multi-million dollar inventory of new, used, and refurbished furniture, you're sure to find exactly what you're looking for. From desks to chairs, filing cabinets, and so much more.
All the major brands that you're looking for. Office Products, we buy right so you can too.
Office Products, we do things right.
Clear to zip.
Break a little. Pesker! Very good job. Game on.
Welcome to Madison HD Sportsnet. My name is Kat Miniatakis, and sitting here with me today is Dominic Richards of JMU football. Dominic, it's a beautiful Monday here on the JMU campus.
No doubt.
A lighter day, I hear, for football. What is your day looking like?
Mondays are actually usually our day off, per se. The NCAA allows us a day off per week. So usually the guys will, we don't have any lifting, we don't have any actual practice. Go to school, you know, come back, and it's a big film day on Mondays, not actual physical, you know, practice. So we'll come in, we'll watch film, get a little jump start into the week, and that's about it. So,
and definitely much needed, especially after these past few games. The JMU offense has been putting up ridiculous numbers, over 1,300 yards total offense, and you guys average a two-minute drive. Being an offensive lineman with such an explosive offense going, how do you keep up with it? What do you guys do specifically?
I gotta say, first and foremost, our strength and conditioning coach, Aaron Burkhart, gets us ready months before the season. I mean, we're trained from January until now, you know, to get ready for our offense. Clearly, it's a lot different than your normal offense, and defenses have trouble with that, but he gets us ready, and he kind of gets us geared up and does specific drills to get us into the zone and into our offensive scheme, so that helps a lot.
Now, I have to ask the question. When you were recruited to JMU, what was the position you were expected to play?
I was a tight end here for a little over 2.5 years, probably 3 years, when Mickey Matthews was head coach. I was obviously recruited as a tight end, played 2 years, redshirted my freshman year. The new staff came, they said, you know, put on 20 pounds and become an O-lineman, so took it in stride. You know, that's not something that everybody, you know, takes very dearly, but, you know, I took it in stride, I made the best of it, and now I'm sitting at center, so, you know, it's going well. And we've had, I'm not the only one like that, we've had multiple guys that have switched. You know, you have Aaron Stinney, you have Matt Frank, who've kind of bounced around, and they're doing equally as well, so.
And you talk about this transition from tight end to an tight end to an O-lineman, and then to center.
Yeah.
What has been the easiest part of that transition?
The easiest part is, I'm not sure. I mean, I think the coaches don't make it a hard transition. I mean, they want you to excel no matter what you're doing. So they make it an easier process. I mean, last season I played every game as a guard. I was a right guard. This spring I was a tackle for the entire spring. And I learned probably mid-July that I was going to be the center. So, you know, I kind of just, like I said before, took it day by day, got better at what I needed to get better at. I mean, I'm grateful that the coaches kind of took it slow and respected that it's going to take me a few weeks during camp to get used to it. And they did, and, you know, that allowed me to get a lot better at it. So now we're rolling. I'm happy with it.
And when you talk about getting used to the position, what is the hardest thing that you've had to adjust to?
Especially with center, I mean, it's one thing to be a guard and a tackle and not have your hand on the ball the whole time. I mean, when you're a center, you need to look at the fronts, you need to look at the backers, you need to look at the safeties, you need to call everything out, and you also need to snap the ball and, you know, get your hand up. I think that's the entire grand scheme of being a center and calling everything out. That's the hardest part. But my offensive line coach, you know, Coach Powell, made it very easy. He was a former center. He taught me a lot of things, and he made the transition a lot easier for me. So,
now looking past, this is your senior year, leaving JMU. I heard that you're into hunting, specifically pheasant hunting. Is that a job that you're looking to pick up, or no? I've seen some photos; they look pretty intense.
No. That is certainly not a job. No, I do love hunting. I'm from Northeast Pennsylvania, so pheasants are very common in Northeast PA. Not very common down here at all. But no, my girlfriend and I actually, we go out and we'll shoot some pheasants, so it's fun. I also deer hunt and stuff like that. So.
Alrighty. Well, for Matazone HD Sportsnet, I'm Kat Miniatakis. With me, Dominic Richards. Everyone enjoy your day.
Harrisonburg Nissan's factory-authorized year-end clearance sale is going on now. Harrisonburg Nissan has all in-stock 2015 Nissans priced at or below factory invoice. And you keep a rebate. 0% financing on Nissan Altima, Rogue, Sentra. All invoices clearly posted. Savings up to and over $8,000. We're clearing out the 15s to make room for the 16s. Now's the best time to buy. Harrisonburg Nissan's factory-authorized year-end clearance sale. Going on now. Check us out 24/7. HarrisonburgNissan.com.
So you can too.
That's right. At Office Products, we do things right. With our multi-million dollar inventory of new, used, and refurbished furniture, you're sure to find exactly what you're looking for. From desks to chairs, filing cabinets, and so much more.
All the major brands that you're looking for. Office Products, we buy right so you can too.
Office Products, we do things right.
Clear to zip.
Break a little. Pesker! Very good job. Game on.
Welcome back, everyone. Time now to talk about the next opponent for the Dukes as they go up and play an FBS opponent. It's the Mustangs of SMU from the American Athletic Conference. We go down to Dallas. Dukes have never played in Texas before. We want to play in Texas again, quite frankly. But the head coach there is Chad Morris.
Right.
He is in his first year at SMU. Mm-hmm. But you've had contact with Chad before as you've encountered him in the ACC and in the Big Ten.
Yeah. Chad was obviously the offensive coordinator at Clemson. And when I was in North Carolina, I had an opportunity to go against him in North Carolina. Very, very up-tempo offense. Does a nice job. Going to be a little bit of a mirror image of what we do a little bit. So that'd be good. And then when I was at Ohio State, we played him in Orange Bowl. Very, very good football coach. Very qualified offensive mind. Does a great job. And he's got his team playing really, really hard and physical.
He has a quarterback that was recruited by some of the big names around the country, and that is Matt Davis. And he is definitely a dual threat. He may be the best football athlete the Dukes will play this year.
Yeah, very talented kid that can throw it, can run it. He can change a game. And we're going to have to do a very good job of knowing where he is on every single play and having somebody assigned to him in the run game and the pass game.
Well, he keeps the ball about a quarter of their overall plays. Yeah. Whenever they rush the ball, he's about 37%. So you know he's going to try to do something.
No question. He's a big part of their offense, and he's probably the best threat on their offense, though they have a number of guys at running back and receiver. But he's probably the biggest threat on that offense.
Well, they come in at 1-2, but they've played Baylor. Yep. They've played TCU. Those were the two losses. They beat North Texas. Right. But what have you seen from them defensively? Because they are giving up some points.
Yeah, but they're a very physical, fast-flowing downhill defense. And they move a good bit up front. They do some things in coverage, a little bit more of a 4-4 defensive scheme. But very, trigger happy off the edges with their Sam and their free safety. So they're very, very active up front. So, we got a challenge on offense to move the ball and score points.
I think you were only thrown for one loss last week on the ground. Mm-hmm. That'll be key this week, positive yardage.
No question. We've got to keep the chains moving. We've got to be able to run the football. We've got to be able to stop the run on the other side. But keeping the chains moving is going to be important.
All right, the Dukes and the Mustangs in Dallas. And that game can be seen on ESPN3 and your ESPN watch as well. So that wraps up this week's edition of the Coach Everett Withers Show. I'm Kurt Dudley for Head Coach Everett Withers. Have a great football week.
Harrisonburg Nissan's factory-authorized year-end clearance sale is going on now. Harrisonburg Nissan has all in-stock 2015 Nissans priced at or below factory invoice. And you keep the rebates. 0% financing on Nissan Altima, Rogue, Sentra. All invoices clearly posted. Savings up to and over $8,000. We're clearing out the 15s to make room for the 16s. Now's the best time to buy. Harrisonburg Nissan's factory-authorized year-end clearance sale. Going on now. Check us out 24-7. HarrisonburgNissan.com.
So you can too.
That's right. At Office Products, we do things right. With our multi-million dollar inventory of new, used, and refurbished furniture, you're sure to find exactly what you're looking for. From desks to chairs, filing cabinets, and so much more.
All the major brands.